Hi, my name's Jared Finney. I'm the tunnel agent for the Old Oak Common SCL tunnels. Welcome to Victoria Road crossover box, where we're going to take you down to the SCL tunnels and give you a bit of an update of where we are and what we've been busy building. So here we are, stood inside Victoria Road crossover box, where behind me you can see the two tunnel portals for the Old Oak Common East SCL tunnels. So since the last update, we've been tunneling here for over a year. We've been tunneling towards Old Oak Common Station. And then from within the same box, two TBMs have made their journey east for the construction of the Northolt Tunnels. So the purpose of these SCL tunnels here behind us are to allow us to connect Victoria Road crossover box to the Old Oak Common Station. So as you can see behind, the tunnel's quite a large diameter. This is to allow for track separation as the trains approach to Old Oak Common Station. So now we're gonna head down and take a look at the progress we've been making in the SCL tunnels. So here we are, stood inside the Uppine Tunnel. Its section size is the largest section within the tunnel, it's 14 and a half meters. This is completely enlarged. So as you can see, the guys have made a huge amount of progress over the last year. We've done a series of top headings, benches and inverts in order to get us to this stage. So these tunnels are created using spray concrete lining, which is a concrete that has fibers within. And what these fibers do is they add additional tensile strength to the concrete. So to construct the tunnel to this size, we break it down into a series of sequences. So we typically go through with a pilot tunnel, which you would have seen last time, and then break it down into a top heading, a bench, and an invert in order to minimize ground settlement to be able to achieve a full enlargement. Typically, we excavate the ground in 1 meter sections. So once the ground is excavated and the clay is removed, we then apply a small section of spray concrete lining, and this thickness varies from about 300 to 450 mil thick. And the reason why we only excavate at a meter is due to the geology and based on the ground conditions, that's what we are allowed by the designers. So here we are, welcome to the downline tunnel where you can see that we are mid construction of the tunnel invert. Here we use the tunnel excavator to construct the lower section of the tunnel. We call this the invert. Once the clay is completely removed and it's dug to the profile, they will then come along and spray the SCL primary lining. So the plant that we use is specifically designed for the size of the tunnel. So as you'll see, we have specifically designed excavators. These are large tunnel excavators specifically designed with articulating arms to allow us to dig the profile. And for us to apply the spray concrete lining, we use specifically designed robots. These are controlled by an operator and a remote control. And what it allows us to do is to be able to spray it at height without putting anyone at risk. So during construction, we could be using anywhere up to 100 meter cube of concrete per day. To be able to keep up with this demand, we have located a batching plant on site. So this allows us the flexibility to be able to batch 24/7 around the clock. And this allows us to get the concrete to site very quickly to allow us to get it sprayed on the lining as soon as possible. So as you can see, we've been making great progress on the Old Oak Common SCL tunnels. Once we have completed the primary lining, we will then move into the next phase of works, which is the secondary lining. What the secondary lining involves is the application of a sheet membrane to the entire circumference of the tunnel. We will then cast the secondary lining inverts, and then we will bring in a specialist formwork, which will create the nice finished concrete profile of the tunnel. So thank you for joining us on this visit. We hope you've enjoyed seeing the progress we've been making, and we hope to update you again in the future.